After 2.5 years, the rest of Dojunim's family immigrated to the United States. Far from the celebrated martial culture of Korea, America was a harsh contrast.
What I remember of the first Dojang in America here was that it was actually quite small. You'd probably say it was less than 1,000 square feet. So it's definitely a downsizing from what our experiences were in Korea.
Despite Hwarang Do's humble American roots, it appeared that their fortunes would change with the arrival of a wounded Vietnam veteran.
When this man by the name of Michael Echanis came to my father, he did not accept him. My father has experience in dealing with Korean military personnel who worked the DMZ, and they saw many deaths. You know, they've made many kills. And those people have a different energy, and he recognizes that. So when he first met Michael Echanis, he didn't think that he would be good for the civilian sector and might be a threat. My father would come back to the Dojang and see him sleeping in the front of the school. And then when my father opened the doors, he would walk in, sit in a corner quietly and watch his instruction all day long until he closed. And he did this for several days.
내가 3일을 테스트한 다음에 제자로 받았습니다. 나는 내 마음, 몸과 마음을 다 바쳐서 마이크를 수련을 시켰지요. 저녁 8시까지 레귤러 학생들을 운동을 시키고 저녁을 먹고 9시부터 새벽 2시, 3시까지 마이크를 집중적으로 수련시켰습니다.
Under Dojunim, Echanis learned the military application of Hwarang Do. He became proficient in all the aspects of hand-to-hand and weapons fighting. And in Echanis, Dojunim saw a valuable opportunity for the preservation of Hwarang Do.
내가 생각할 때 이 미국은 내가 보는 그 충성을 제1로 삼는 군인들이다. 그렇기 때문에 이 미국 군의 화랑도를 가리킴으로써 그들이 앞으로 제대를 하고 나와서 화랑도 도장을 개관을 해서
In 1977, Echanis re-enlisted and taught Hwarang Do to the Special Forces at Fort Bragg. This, along with articles in Black Belt magazine and the publications of books on specialized military hand-to-hand combat, special weapons, and tactics, had Hwarang Do on the verge of breaking through to the mainstream. But that all ended September 1978. Echanis was teaching hand-to-hand combat to the entire National Guard in Nicaragua. During a flight over Nicaragua Lake, his plane exploded.
When my father heard the news of the passing of Echanis, he was heartbroken. My father have always taken in the instructors or his students like his own family, his own sons. He was heartbroken because his martial son have passed away.
The circumstances of his alleged assassination remain a mystery, but the legend of Echanis lives on.
그 여파가 내가 원했던 이 큰 기대가 꺾였던 것입니다. 그러나 그 마이크 이체네스가 아직까지 살아있는 것이에요. 마이크 이체네스한테 배운 모든 화랑도인들이 모든 그 특공대인들이 계속 운동을 하고 있습니다.
Dojunim continued his demonstrations for the public, as well as television, appearing on shows like That's Incredible.
There are some people in this world who have the ability to stop themselves from feeling pain. That's Incredible.
And Unknown Powers with Jack Palance.
The Lee brothers are masters of the Korean martial art, Hwarangdo. Using ki power, they are able to make their bodies lighter, heavier, hard like steel, or capable of blocking out pain.
along with Dojunim, a new face to Hwarangdo was emerging.
In the 80s, I was very busy because now I was of age to perform many of the demonstrations. I remember doing countless numbers of demonstrations from even small kindergarten with an audience of 10 to doing Universal Studios with a capacity of 10,000. When I was around 17, 18 years old, I remember telling my father that, you know, I'm going to follow in your footsteps and I'm going to, you know, do Hwarangdo for my life.
In college, Grandmaster Lee started opening up Hwarangdo clubs across Southern California, spending all his free time traveling from school to school to teach. After college, he set his sights even higher.
In the late 1993, 94, I started looking to open a school in the Los Angeles area because I thought that it would be a good place to attract many students. So my father helped me to open the school.
Grandmaster Lee made it his goal to continue developing Hwarangdo. While still teaching, training, and doing demonstrations, he spearheaded the development of Taesudo, as well as Gotugi, a grappling program, and the revolutionary application of sword fighting with Gumtugi, as well as stick fighting with Bongtugi. All this work, along with his continued consistent training and adherence to the martial way, did not go unnoticed by Dojunim. In May of 2009, Dojunim promoted the then Chief Master Lee with the title of Eighth Dan, giving him the title of Grandmaster, Kuksa Nim, putting him in line to become the next Dojun.
나의 큰 아들이 내가 그 생명을 줬다고 혈육이라 한 것이 아니라 혈육이 아니라도 누구든 화랑도에 충성을 다하고 목숨을 바치면은 그가 화랑도를 최고로 이끌어 나갈 수 있는 사람이다 생각하고 있어요. 그동안 많은 세월을 보아왔습니다만 46년이란 세월을 내 아들을 봤어요. 그가 제일 훌륭한 단을 받게 됐습니다. 나는 내 이태준 국사를 믿습니다. 내 아들로서 믿음과 무도의 후계자로서 믿음으로 믿게 됐습니다.
My father, he has been a mentor to countless others in his 50 years of instruction. I have met many leaders, and in my mind, he is one of among the top leaders of the world in all of history, for sure in the martial arts community. To maintain one single identity and organization for 50 years, I don't know too many people who have dedicated all of their lives, committing to a single idea, a single passion.
50년이라는 한 우물을 파는 이 무도의 길이 나한테 기쁨을 가져주기도 하고 또한 자랑스럽게 만들기도 했습니다. 앞으로 계속하는 화랑도 사범들은 절대 약속을 어기지 마십시오. 그것이 무도의 길입니다. 내가 그 약속을 이행함으로써 당신은 성공하는 것입니다. 이 화랑도를 수련하면서 50년이라는 세월을 유수와 같이 보냈습니다. 지금도 나는 할 일이 너무 많습니다. 할 일이 너무 많은데 시간이 너무 빨리 가고 있습니다. 나의 화랑도 열정은 죽을 때까지입니다. 나는 은퇴가 없습니다. 왜냐하면 은퇴는 내가 죽은 날입니다. 무엇이 나를 이렇게 만드는 것이냐? 화랑도의 사랑입니다. 내 스승님과 약속했던 이 무도의 세계의 보급을 나는 죽을 때까지 할 것입니다. 아니 죽어서도 할 것입니다. 여러분들이 그 뒤를 이어준다면 화랑도는 수천 년을 계승할 수 있을 것입니다.